Hey YouTube, it's the main man here, aka Esper, aka Fable, aka H2O, okay, the many nicknames fiasco. Back at it again with more Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Trilogy series. Let's see, gonna be part 4 I think this time. Thank you to those who've been watching, or and I appreciate it very much. And I will be back next week, maybe to upload more, probably, hopefully. College, whining. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, those who do watch. And yeah, hope you enjoy. Bye!
Court is back in session for the trial of Mr. Powers. The prosecution has a concern. As our witness is a grade schooler of tender years, and this is a murder case, we worry that the defense might cause unnecessary drama with his cruel questioning. You're so annoying. Nice to see Edgeworth taking the moral high ground, yeah.
Sir, if anyone is cruel when it comes to questioning, it's you. Like, what?
However, we have no choice. The prosecution calls Cody Hackins to the stand.
Get the hell out of my face. He doesn't even, stand past the podium. That's funny.
Your Honor, perhaps you could arrange a box for him to stand on?
Oh, right.
Guard, please bring him a box. One of those donut grates should do.
Wow.
Will the witness state his name and grade in school?
Apparently he won't. Had to let my cat out. Witness, he does not like you. This child, I hope he doesn't like you.
What? Just because you're all grown up doesn't mean you can push me around, period.
Yeah. Yeah, let him know. Let him know. Yeah, he don't like you. At all. This child does not like you. Don't act like you're on good terms. Please.
Cody? Answer his question for me, okay?
Hey, it's you, the nice lady. That's right, baby. That's right.
I'm Cody Hackins. I'm in second grade.
Second? Wow, that explains a lot. I get the feeling this is going to be a long, long day.
Mr. Edgeworth, please remember that you're speaking to a child. Try to be gentle.
Witness, I mean Cody.
He really is. What an annoying man. Wow.
Is not good with children.
No.
You were present,
yeah.
You were at Global Studios on the day of the incident.
You got a problem with that?
Please tell us what you saw that day.
What, Pops? You want me to tell you and Gramps with the beard over there?
Just Mr. Edgeworth will be fine. I prefer bearded gentlemen.
I didn't even fully read what he said, but I know their feelings were hurt.
Incidentally, photographic equipment is strictly forbidden in this courtroom.
Huh? What? Wait, pause. What?
What did he say?
I didn't even remember what specifically was asked of the child, but
my apologies, Your Honor. He said he wouldn't testify if he couldn't bring it.
I'd like special permission if that's possible.
So you're saying you had to bargain terms with a kid, and you lost?
Yeah.
Listen, if you're as stubborn as this child, I believe it.
Hey, I just got this new camera. Don't really know how to use it all that good yet. But I bring it with me wherever I go.
Phoenix, I wonder if you had that camera on the day of the murder. You better make a note of it in the court record.
Cody's camera. A new digital camera. Cody always carries it, though he's learning how to use it.
Anyways.
Very well, Cody. Please testify to the court about what you saw the day of the incident.
My least favorite OST in this game. To be honest, I'm not gonna lie. I wanted to see a Steel Samurai rehearsal just once. I found a map on the internet and went to the studios that day.
I went through the woods off the path so that old lady wouldn't catch me. I was going for the studio. I got lost on the way, though, for about 30 minutes. When I came out by the studio, there was a steel samurai. It totally rocked! Right before my eyes, out came the bad guy. Of course, the steel samurai took him down. Pow! This kid does not know what happened at all. He does not... Does he not process the fact that someone died in front of him? Really? If I had my camera with me, that would have been the time for a shot, I tell you. He didn't have it. Anyway, I couldn't get into the studio, so I went home. I see.
Very well. The defense may begin its cross-examination. But be gentle. Remember, you're talking to a child.
Whatever. This kid is tougher than most adults we see in here. I wanted to see a Steel Samurai rehearsal just once. Okay. Found a map on the internet. Went through the woods. I got lost on the way for almost 30 minutes. Okay. I see. Like the Steel Samurai, huh? Of course I do. I taped every show. Taped? How old is this game? Good God. taped? And I got to go to all the live performances. That's impressive. Have you been to the amusement park? Of course, duh. My dad always takes me. Poor dad. Yeah. I found a map on the internet and went to the studios that day. The same day? Was that day the first time you'd been to the studio? Actually, I've been a couple times. I never managed to get there on rehearsal day. And that security lady's always yelling. I'm getting to it. Chill, Pops. How am I supposed to talk with you cutting me off all the time? Jeez! Damn. Off the path. Yeah, you know how the studios are in the valley there. Or you know how, okay, different tone. If you go off the path a little, there's woods. That's where I was. I see. Anyhow. The kid's not gonna be lying, so there's probably almost zero point to this, but I'm just doing it because why not? Did nothing unusual happen on your way to the studio? Unusual. Did you see this monkey by any chance? Oh, you mean Mr. Monkey? Yeah, I saw him, but his head wasn't busted. So you went straight to the studio. I got kind of lost. You got lost in the woods. I couldn't figure out which way I was walking. Man, was I relieved when I saw the blue studio doors. But guess what happened next? The Steel Samurai. Yes, he was standing by the studio gate. It looked like he was thinking about something before going in. Then he opened the gate and went inside. I see. What then? It totally rocked. Right before my eyes, out came the bad guy. A guy? A person? Kind of tall, skinny. Are you sure it was a guy? I don't know. He was kind of far away. He is... Steel Samurai took him down. Pow! Alright. What happened to the bad guy? Huh? Well, he kinda didn't move. Not a bit. Like he was dead. Do you really not know? Can you not put that together in your head? You're in second grade. I guess he was a real pro. Okay, I see. What a great actor. Damn. If you had your camera? You mean you weren't carrying your camera then? No, I wasn't. It's not like I have it all the time, but you stated you do. Really? I guess seeing the killing freaked him out and then he went home. Phoenix, remember he's a child. Use gentle words, but be firm.
Alright. Alright.
So you wanted to see the rehearsal. Contains photo of every battle scene, every victory scene, and every battle with Stale Samurai has won. He always carries it, but he didn't have it with him at the time. Okay. What? Oh fuck, I forgot to save. No. It's fine. Okay. Hold on. Shit, let me save real quick. Hold on. Yikes. Okay, you found a map. I went through the woods off the path so that old lady wouldn't catch me. Yeah. Da-da. I was going for the studio. I got lost on the way though for about 30 minutes. Well damn. PM, you got lost for 30 minutes. Nope. I went through the woods off the path so that old lady wouldn't catch me. Let's see. Went from the studio, got lost on the way. Yeah, that's not related. Damn it. Clearly. It rocked right before my eyes, the bad guy. Yeah. Okay, took him down. If I had my camera. Alright. Cody, what you just said. Oops. Sorry, that's the dinner alarm. Whoopsies. Cody, what you just said seems, well, a little strange. Didn't you say before that you always bring your digital camera wherever you go? You were quite clear about that. Huh? Cody, you shouldn't lie here. You understand that, right? Mr. Wright, a word with you. Piss off. What is this digital camera contraption you're talking about? What? It's a digital camera, Your Honor. It's kind of a new sort of camera. I see. Anyways, Cody, I can't believe you wouldn't bring your camera on a trip to the studios. Yeah, that's gotta be a lie, for sure. I figured that was the most likely lie, but I wanted to try everything else first, mostly. You did bring it, didn't you? Don't use him being a child as an excuse, either. Don't do it. How cruel you are to terrorize a child, a poor child, so you don't like children. Shut up. I don't care if he's a child or a prosecuting attorney. No one should lie in court. Facts. What do you mean, or a prosecuting attorney? Oop. Well, Cody. Oh, shade. That was wow. That was direct shade towards Edgeworth right there. Wow. Shit, Miles, get your sunglasses. God damn. Well, not shade, actually. Wait, shade? Yeah, get your sunglasses. I don't even know. What am I saying? Should have rolled with it. Yeah, so I have my camera. So what? You got a problem with that? So, did you have a camera? And did you use this camera? What? Why would I use it? I was too busy watching. Very well. Please testify to the court about what you are so busy watching. Mm-hmm. Very well. Please testify to the court about what you were so busy watching.
What I saw...
Well?
Yeah, I had my camera with me.
Lying ass.
But I was glued to the action. I couldn't take my eyes off it. The steel samurai goes for the bad guy. Wham! Then, the bad guy stopped moving. He's so strong, the steel samurai rules. Ooh, it's child.
That was horrible. Is that all? Well, that was brief. Your cross-examination, please. That was the briefest testimony I've ever heard in this game. Or I believe I could ever hear. Period. Let's see. Yeah, I had my camera with me. That checks out. But I was glued to the action. I couldn't take my eyes off it. The steel samurai goes for the bad guy. Goes for the bad guy. Okay, never mind. Goes for the bad guy. Wham! Now, with the spear, dragging his leg. Contains photos of every scene. Then the bad guy stopped moving. He's so strong. The steel samurai rules. The bad guy stopped moving. Okay, wait, no, actually, what I should be doing, I didn't even think about that, no. I should be, pressing him for everything he said. So why didn't you use it? He's getting to that. Relax and listen. I didn't use it because I was too busy watching the real thing. So you were watching the Steel Samurai, did you watch the whole fight? Yeah, of course. You didn't turn away, not even once? No. Okay then, tell us exactly what happened. Yeah, I'm getting to that. Goes for the bad guy, wham! Yep, so the bad guy attacked first? What sort of person was the bad guy? I told you, a person, he was a person. How was he dressed? I kinda don't remember. Stupid. I'm sorry, he in second grade, but at the same time, you cannot be so selective here. You recall the fight, and you recall the action sequences that took place, right? You see the punch that was thrown, you see the wham and all this stuff, but you don't remember who he was fighting, even though you were watching so intensely. That's what you forgot? Come on now. I'm sorry. Like, what? I see, and what happened next? Then the bad guy stopped moving. Why? Huh? What do you mean, why? Why wasn't the bad guy moving? Well, because the steel samurai brought him to justice, no. And how exactly did he do that? How did he do it? With a samurai kick and a samurai punch, samurai chop, samurai slap, something like that. Yeah, that's bad, dude. What? Don't give me that look, Pops. I can always wait. Or I can choose whatever, because I already have a save slot, so... Press him about it. Cody.
What?
Something's bothering me. Before you said that you couldn't take your eyes off the action. Yeah, so what? Did you miss the most important part? What is the meaning of this? The witness has stated that he saw quite clearly.
Clearly what?
No, he didn't. You know as well as I do that he's being vague. Tell me, what kind of murderer uses a samurai slap? My point is this. Cody, you may have seen some of Steel Samurai's fight, but you missed the most important part, the killing blow. Yeah, this is a real courtroom. To even be saying He don't know. This child doesn't know. He doesn't know nothing. It's okay. I'm just like, wow. Mr. Wright, how could this be? Can you explain how he might have missed something so vital?
Well, that's the thing. Phoenix, I believe you're on the right track with this. Think, why didn't Cody see the climax of the fight?
I know you. You can figure this out.
Mr. Wright, your answer. We have ascertained that this young boy is a great fan of the Steel Samurai. Why wouldn't he watch the climax of the fight? He couldn't watch. He was watching something else.
Fuck. Okay. Why wouldn't he? Contains photos. Why couldn't he watch?
No, taking a photo would mean he was watching hell even more intensely than a usual person or a usual bystander.
Let's see. Lasagna and dynamite? Dynamitas. I don't know what the dynamitas part is, but this sounds fire. Hi, Nico. Hope you're having a good night. Welcome. How you doing? Also, lasagna sounds fire.
I love lasagna.
Let's see. Why wouldn't he watch?
I have a save. Can I save right here? Actually,
I can? Wow.
Oh, shit. Where did I go?
To be honest, I don't know which is which right now. I don't even know which... What the fuck? Is it 10? I don't know where I'm at. Okay. He couldn't watch it?
Which one do I pick?
Let's say he couldn't. Because he couldn't watch it. How could he calmly watch a murder taking place at his age? And he didn't see it happen, so he doesn't know who died, if someone died. It's like Takis, but less thick and corny. Slender and spicy. Ah! Oh, you're a hot chip person? Interesting. I am not. I used to fucking love hot Cheetos, dude. That was my shit. That was my snack. But then I ascended to being a Funyuns lover, so. That's me. But that sounds good. I've heard of those chips now. Yeah, it does sound spicy. One thing has become quite clear in this boy's testimony. He did not believe he was witnessing a murder. I'm about to have some fish and rice soon. Okay. Specifically Red Snapper, so I'm excited. He was watching the Steel Samurai fight, like, on TV. The more real the fight, the more he would have watched. That's bullshit. Do you have another explanation? We have ascertained... Yeah, whatever. Okay. He was watching something else. Maybe. This child is very... bad at descriptions, so he clearly was not paying attention to his biggest idol, Steel Samurai. He had a 64 variety bag. Nice. And yes, Red Snapper! I'm excited. Because what is it? My favorite fish is catfish, but Red Snapper is actually really fire. Let's see, he missed the climax of the fight because he was looking at something else, probably. Oh, that's too vague. Never mind, I gotta show evidence. That is way too vague. Stop it. What was he looking at? Yeah. What do you claim he was looking at? Yeah. Come on now. Yeah, nothing else was mentioned. I have evidence. Evidence? Why did Cody look away from the fight? Why, specifically? Every victory scene. I have no idea. I don't know the reason. But I want to say this. Here's my proof. Can I do that again? That's terrible. Wow. Why would he not watch the fight? I don't know. Let me read. Time of death, because he was pierced. No, he didn't see the killing blow. Dragging a leg. What? No. Guide map? I don't know. That wouldn't make any sense. He couldn't watch it. He didn't fall asleep out there or something like that. I don't know. Why did Cody look away? Oh, because of this. This would be distracting, right? This falling and creating a commotion. Maybe. Damn it. Really? Oh my god, what else could distract him? I have no idea. No one drugged the child. He didn't eat anything there. It's not the camera. It's not this. It's not this. It's not this. It can't be this. What? I had to mute real quick because I had to sneeze. Ew. What the fuck? Why did he look away? From the fight itself? This one makes sense either. What? I don't know which of these evidence... what actually aligns with what the hell he's saying. This is weird. Why did he look away? God damn it. Like, what? Okay. Still learning how to use it? Maybe he looked away to take a test photo? That'd be stupid. Why would this be proof? The witness stated that he recently received this camera. Yes, I'm aware of that. He wasn't entirely familiar with its operation. I'm aware of that as well. Ah, correct. Why would Cody be looking elsewhere at the critical moment? This is annoying. Ugh. I don't know. I don't like that one only because you kind of have to follow a random path of logic to be like, oh, he had a new camera. Maybe he was trying to fiddle with it at that very moment before he took a photo or something like that. That's annoying, but whatever. Because he was looking at his camera. Hey! Bullseye. Why would you lie about that? The fuck? What's your problem, Pops? You got a thing for picking on kids? Pressing, not picking. Good job, Phoenix. Cody was lying, clearly. Smart of you to realize there was no way he could just stand there watching his hero. Yeah, I'm like, what? That would not make sense. And not take a picture. Right, Cody? There was only one reason why you would have looked away from the fight. And that was because you wanted to take a picture. But having just received your camera, you weren't used to using it yet. So you missed the climax of the fight, correct? Yeah, fake ass. Talking about, oh, I seen everything. Why would you lie? At least he wasn't traumatized by seeing someone die. Maybe. I mean, he kind of did, but he didn't see the actual killing blow. I'll bet you anything he's hiding more than that. Have him testify again. That's right, Mia. Your Honor, the defense would like to request that Cody Hackins testify once more. Very well. Cody? Could you please tell us about your camera, and why you didn't take a picture of the fight? Welcome to the real world, kid. Yeah. Tell him. Yeah, you're right, Pops. The Steel Samurai had just escaped from the clutches of the villain. What? So I held up my camera to take a picture, but the lens wouldn't open in time, so I missed it. That's all that happened. Yup. Okay, you're lying. Again, why are you still lying? You suck at lying. It's the way they do it. Not you suck at lying. No, it's more like it's the way they accurately represent how kids think they're good at lying. But then they'll say some unnecessary thing to like just make the whole thing fall apart. It's weird. I don't get it. But really funny. Anything strange in that testimony, Mr. Wright? I'm not sure. But I'd like to proceed with the examination, excuse me. No photo. You're right, Pops. I had just escaped the clutches of the villain. To me, this fits fuck. I don't know which one to load, so I'm just gonna leave it alone. I don't care. I had just escaped the evil clutches of the villain, so I held up my camera to take a picture, but the lens went open, and I missed it. Yep, that's all that happened. This aligns with the photo here. Excuse me. I'll be right back, though. I gotta go get my fish.
Fish and rice acquired! I'm happy.
Now, I'm fully equipped to defeat this case. Now. Or... seal the case. Anyways. Let's see. So this checks out in relation to this, in my opinion. This evidence clearly... what? Oh, it's supposed to contradict. Okay, my bad. I was about to say, I'm like, what are you talking about? Sure, okay. I held up my camera to take a photo. Something that contradicts, but the lens wouldn't open. That's all that happened. That's all? Yeah, I told you I didn't take a picture. I would have, once I got that lens open. Did he really not take a picture? Not even one? No, press this child. Nah, he definitely would have taken a photo. There's gotta be something here I can use. Cody, listen up. Cody Hackens, I know exactly what happened that day. You took a picture. Hey! How did you know? Oh my god. I see through all your lies, Cody. It's one of my powers. You're lying! I hate when they do that too. This feels great, yep. Yeah, I took a picture. Perhaps you can change your testimony to reflect this, Cody? I took a few shots, but it was too late, so I erased them. You what? You erased them? Off the camera, yeah. Why would you erase a picture of your beloved Steel Samurai? Well, you know, why would I want to keep a picture like that? What picture? How could I pick holes in such a short testimony? There has to be something. Dig up the dirt, Phoenix. Find out what this kid's all about. You're right, Pops. Anyways. I took photos, but erased them. You erased them? You keep a scrapbook of stuff, dude. What? Man, every time you say Cody, you follow it with something bad. I just wanted to thank you for giving me this the other day. Huh? Oh, right. What was it you told me then? I go to every live performance. Why is there not... is there no auto-read function? Like, actually. No? Damn, nothing. You gotta read through it. All of it. I always take a picture when the Steel Samurai lands the final blow. Wazam! I got them all. I've never missed one. A perfect collection. A weirdo. Cody, did you really get a picture of the Steel Samurai standing victorious over his foe? If you did, I find it hard to believe that you would erase it. Wouldn't you keep it for your album? Ah! Mr. Wright, what exactly is this album? It's called Path to Glory. It's a collection of pictures of the Steel Samurai, all taken by Cody Hackens. He claims it's a perfect collection of every battle the Steel Samurai has won. I see. Don't you find this odd, Your Honor? Among all his pictures, the Steel Samurai of the Steel Samurai, none were taken that day. Order! Mr. Wright, have you an explanation? If the Steel Samurai had just defeated his adversary, I certainly would expect to see a picture of it in this album. Exactly my point, Your Honor. I'm trying to break apart this fish. I'm taking a bite. No, wait, no way. I think we finally discovered the truth.
What?
And what a truth it is. Are we sure about this?
Yes.
I'm pretty sure what you're thinking is right. Tell him, Phoenix. Tell him what the truth is.
Oh, shit.
Why was there no picture in the album from the day of the murder? Oh, so it was the child. They were blurry. The Steel Samurai didn't win. Oh, never mind. Wait. Huh? Why is my life on the line right now to answer the question? My only answer is the Steel Samurai would not win, or did not win, because he wouldn't want to save that. He's like, oh, he lost. I can only think of one reason, Your Honor. The Steel Samurai didn't win. That's why Cody deleted the photos. Well, Cody, I'm right, aren't I? Tell the truth, the bad guy defeated the Steel Samurai. No, no way. Okay, never mind. The Steel Samurai never loses. Never. He's too much of a fanboy. He has no reason to try and be a murderer. He never loses to anyone, ever. Your Honor, the witness has revealed everything with his words. There was a reason why he lied and told us that he didn't take a picture. The same reason he erased his precious photos. For Cody, it was inconceivable that the Steel Samurai could be defeated. However, Cody witnessed the impossible. He saw the Steel Samurai lose. Yet to admit what he saw would destroy everything he believed in. That's why he lied and said the Steel Samurai won. He couldn't handle the truth. Interesting. So someone... Wait. Huh? That is confusing. The Steel Samurai didn't win. Wait, I'm like, did someone kill... Huh. This is weird. Okay. Witness, I mean Cody, is this true? What did you see? Tell the court what you saw. I... Shut the hell up. This is so annoying. That day you saw the Steel Samurai lose a fight, right? Okay. You're right, the Steel Samurai fell down. Then he didn't move. Okay, what kind of stunt are you trying to pull? The Steel Samurai was the murderer, not the victim. Yet according to your testimony, the Steel Samurai was the one who fell. Your witness's testimony, anyway. Somebody, I don't understand it at all. This is weird. This is really weird. So they were in their armor by that point in time. What the fuck? The Steel Samurai died. So that means, wait, what? Somebody killed him in the steel. So has anyone found the costume? Has no one verified, like, oh, there's a hole in the Steel Samurai outfit? No one? Apparently we have all made a serious error. An error? What's this all about? Hammer was the victim. Steel Samurai was the victim. There was no victim? Shit. Okay, I'm saving this, bitch. What? Okay. Hammer was the victim. I mean, we knew that. We thought that. Steel Samurai was the victim? Yes. If you understand what really happened, it's quite simple.
At the end of the fight, the Steel Samurai fell to the ground and lay still. In other words, the Steel Samurai was not the killer, but he was the victim. Don't you see? Jack Hammer was the Steel Samurai. Yeah, so I'm like, when did they switch? Order, order! So the Steel Samurai in this photograph, you're saying the man in the costume was the victim, Jack Hammer? That's what I'm saying, Your Honor. Jack Hammer was present at the action scene run through that morning. Thus, he obviously knew about Will Powers' foot injury. Hadn't Mr. Hammer gone to the Studio One already? That's what everyone thought. But remember what Miss Oldbag said in her testimony? On the day of the murder, I arrived at the guard station at 1 p.m. Did I see Old Hammer? Nope. He'd already gone back to the studio before I got back to the guard station. Mr. Jackhammer left the employee area after lunch. However, no one saw him going to Studio One, nor was there a picture of him. Yet, so he waited for Mr. Powers to take a nap in his dressing room. Then he snuck into the dressing room and stole the samurai costume. Okay, then who's the murderer? But why would the victim do such a thing? I don't know. I get it. I thought that the Steel Samurai was moving strange, so it was a different person in the suit. Pops. Actually, there was one piece of data I saved. Yeah, a photo on my digital camera. Show us. No way, man, not if you're gonna look at me like that. Now. Here, this is it. Huh? He's going to Studio 2. Looks like. Well, looking at this, it's a little hard to say. I'm afraid that it could be anyone in that costume. Your opinion, Mr. Wright? I agree, Your Honor. This isn't decisive evidence. I'm sorry, this doesn't look like it's the proof we need. I'll give it back. Wait, Phoenix. Look at that photo once more. Yeah, that's it, Phoenix. That's the photo. That photo is all the evidence you need to win this trial. Your Honor, may I see that photo one more time, please? Certainly. I don't see why not. Phoenix, show him. There's a glaring and decisive inconsistency with the facts as we know them in that photo. Find the inconsistency in the photo. It's Studio 2. Now move. Your Honor, look at this. A gate? Might I draw your attention to the number on the gate? The number? Ah yes, well, it's hard to see, but it looks like a 2. Clearly not a 1, Your Honor, correct? Ah! Mr. Edgeworth sees what I'm getting at. What? That's impossible! Eh? What's this all about? Please explain so that I might be shocked, along with the rest of the court. I'll use the studio guide map. The body was found here in Studio 1. However, what do we see in this photo taken at the time of the murder? It does not say Studio 1 on that gate in the photo. Your Honor, here is the true scene of the crime. Studio 2. Here, at Studio 2. I see. That would explain the 2. Come on now. Your Honor, I find it very significant that the murder took place in Studio 2. The trailer was there, the path was blocked, bitch. What? The block was passed. Wow. Oof. That's a don't do drugs moment right there. Wow. Bitch. Wow. The block was passed. Wow. Okay. No filming is done there. No filming is no longer being used. I see. And this is significant. Why? Stabbing away, Your Honor.
Damn it. Okay, the path was blocked. The path was blocked at 2:15. In other words, the victim went to the studio, went to Studio 2 before that time. I suppose that would be the case. Remember Mr. Salmonella's testimony? Allow me to remind the court. He said no one in the trailer was guilty because they could not have gone to the Studio 1. Yet, in actuality, the reverse was true. Only someone in the trailer could have committed this murder. They were the only ones with access to the scene of the crime, Studio 2. So it's either Salmonella or the baddie. I forgot her name. The one who smokes. She's cool though. Okay. Or Penny. Maybe Penny. I don't think Penny was there though. As you may recall, there's a trailer in Studio 2. Now on that day, a meeting was held in that very trailer. There was a break in the meeting corresponding to the time of death. During that break, Mr. Salmonella and Miss D. Vasque were outside eating steak. They were at the scene of the crime. Order! The defense makes the following claims. The scene of the crime was Studio 2. The person that the security guard, Miss Oldbag, saw was the victim, Mr. Jack Hammer. Mr. Hammer, for some reason, stole a samurai costume. Then he went to Studio 2. This is madness. Mr. Jack Hammer is the victim. The victim. So, why would he steal a samurai costume? Are you suggesting that he did so to cover up the details of his own murder? Well, of course not. Or do you have proof? Give me proof that the victim, Jack Hammer, stole the costume. Shit. That he stole it? I don't have that. He's dragging a leg. That means nothing because that would have. The murder weapon? Proof that he stole the costume? I want to say this, maybe? I have proof. You do? Now that they're so surprised, I'm much less confident. I think I'm right, though. This is it, an empty medicine bottle? I found it on the table in the employee area. The same table where Mr. Hammer and Mr. Powers ate. The label reads, sleeping pills. Sleeping pills? The defendant, Mr. Powers, spent the entire afternoon sleeping. He was drugged by Mr. Hammer. Wait a moment. That bottle does raise some suspicions, yes. But there is no proof that Mr. Hammer used it. I have an idea. Excuse me. I want to check this bottle for fingerprints. If my claim is true, Mr. Hammer's fingerprints should show up on this bottle. I suppose you're right. Very well, the court will take possession of the bottle. The court will suspend proceedings on the current trial for today. Cody Atkins' testimony has revealed new possibilities in this case. In fact, things may have happened very differently than we previously thought. The steel samurai seen by Miss Oldbag may have been the victim, Jack Hammer. The scene of the crime was not Studio 1, but Studio 2.
and those in the trailer did have time to commit murder. Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor?
Your homework is to find the answer to the following. Excuse me. Why would Mr. Hammer steal the samurai costume? Also, who killed him and why? Find the answers for me by tomorrow. Mr. Edgeworth, you will need to reconsider your stance in this case. Above all, you will need to reconsider your suspicion of Mr. Will Powers. As you say, Your Honor. This trial will be extended until tomorrow. This is the last extension.
Very well. The court is adjourned.
All right. October 19th, 2:47 p.m. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 1.
Woo! That was a close one.
You were saved by a hair, but that's all that counts.
I thought seriously about going home about 3 times during the trial.
What? You have no home to go to. What?
Ma'am.
She said she thought about ditching me.
Me too.
Really?
You both seem so confident.
Ha! Maybe I should take a career in acting.
I was ready to pronounce you dead about 3 times back there.
Me too.
Dead?
Of course we're kidding.
Are you sure?
I wasn't kidding. Damn.
We have to go make our final investigation. But I promise you, we'll find the true killer by tomorrow's trial.
Right, thanks.
This is a very elaborate case, like, wow.
Or a complicated case, yeah, also.
Oh man, I was chewing.
October 19th, 3:27 p.m., Wright Incorporated Law Offices.
That was a close one, huh, Mia?
Really? Too bad. I'm sorry I missed it.
Mm-hmm.
Maya!
So, what happened?
Well, I think I've got a pretty good idea about who did it. Now all I need is a motive and proof.
Wow, good going, Nick.
Under the initial trial system, tomorrow is the last day we have.
Initial trial? What's that?
That's the new court system they introduced 2 or 3 years ago.
They had so many cases in the system, they decided to speed the whole process up.
So under that system, trials have to end in 3 days?
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, we've no time to waste.
Why would Mr. Hammer steal the samurai costume?
I have no idea.
What? You mean Mr. Hammer was wearing the costume?
Oh yeah, she didn't hear none of this shit.
Yeah, but Mr. Hammer was the victim.
Why would he go through the trouble of stealing it?
This is weird, unless we know, like, someone was trying to kill Mr. Will Powers.
Maybe? That wouldn't make any sense, though. Like,
only because we don't know how close they were. So that theory, I don't think makes sense. Like, to be like, oh, I'm gonna confront this evildoer in your place. And even go to lengths such as drugging you to make sure you won't interfere. And whatever happens, happens. Like, what? No. No.
What happened with the director's testimony?
Well, it's pretty clear that the producer and the director were both in the trailer. Which means that the killer has to be one of them.
Really? Why?
God, they keep catching me lacking. I'm chewing. Because the real scene of the crime was at Studio 2, where the trailer was.
What?
Was Maya always this excitable? Alright, any ideas? Well, have you noticed anything that might help us? I can't see what's going on when Mia isn't here. Wait, is here? So no, I haven't noticed anything. Right, maybe we should go talk to the WP? True. I'm like, do you really not have any recollection of someone entering your room before you went to sleep? Nothing? Nothing? That's terrible. Mr. Wright, you did very well again today.
Thank you.
Did you not look like you're about to burst into tears?
Wow, Nick, you must have really wowed him in there.
And could you wipe that grin off your face?
Yeah.
Man, please. Hey, WP, only one day left. Let's make it count. Well, there's not really anything I can do to help.
I'm not really sure what I can do either.
Please, this is no laughing matter. Anyways. Producer Vasquez. I have no idea. Oh. Somebody will destroy me for not knowing how to pronounce this fucking last name, dude. Somebody will destroy me, but I will keep saying Vasquez as I have been, okay? Vasquez. Producer Vasquez. Could you tell me more about Miss Vasquez?
Oh, the producer?
Yes.
She's well respected in the industry. They say she's a genius.
A genius?
She's been at Global Studios for 5 years now. Right or wrong, nobody dares to tell her different these days.
Why is that? Ever since she came on board, we've had nothing but hits.
Oh, she's the one that fixed up and you could say, what's the word? She saved them from ruin, essentially, right? Like the business crashing.
Global Studios was on its knees, but she picked it up and made it shine.
Oh, and...
Nothing. Forget it. I've only heard rumors, anyhow.
Don't play with me.
Can you tell me anything about Mr. Manella?
Oh, he used to be a... Wait, what? He used to be a minor, straight-to-video director.
But something in his work caught Vasquez's eyes. She brought the Steel Samurai idea to him. Now everyone knows the name Sal Manella. I hear he's pretty much at her beck and call, though. Whenever she says jump, he asks, how high, and all that. I can imagine him being at her beck and call, though I can't imagine him jumping.
How dare you?
I was wondering about Mr. Hammer. He was a big star back in the day, right? But then he just dropped off the face of the earth.
Oh, yes, you're right. In fact, he was my role model when I started in this business. But he just stopped taking on big roles.
That's when he began appearing in little productions at Global.
How could he do that? I was really looking forward to the sequel to Samurai Summer.
He just gave up being a star 5 years ago. Actually, now that I think about it, that was right when Miss Vasquez came to Global.
Interesting. Really? Wow.
Her again. October 19th, Global Studios, Main Gate.
The old windbag sure is quiet today.
Damn.
In front of her face? You know, this place is really peaceful like this. Nick? I think our guard's down.
Yeah? I bet we could even eat those donuts in the guard station if we wanted.
You eat, you die. Woo, she's alive!
Okay.
don't play with me. Don't talk about you eat, you die. Ma'am, we're in the middle of a case. Don't threaten me right now. I'll take you down to the station. I mean, I don't have that authority, but I'll call someone with that authority, okay? I was wondering about Guy Vasquez, the producer. Oh, the studio bigwigs love her. So she always gets her way. She seems bitter. Yeah, about it. Do you not like the producer? Look, the studio people don't want me talking about her, so sorry. Manella, can I tell you about direct... Can you... Bitch, what? Can I ask you about Sal Manella, the director? Sal? He's a soft pushover. He does whatever Vasquez tells him to. She treats him like dirt, but I think he likes it. Why would anyone like being treated like dirt? Some people got that weird kink, girl. Some people... Okay, some people like that shit. It's weird. It's odd. Maybe he's a masochist. We don't know. He's a little weirdo. That doesn't make any sense, does it, Nick? No, it doesn't, Maya. He didn't want to say nothing in front of her. He knows. About Mr. Hammer. I heard about what you said today, cheeky whippersnapper. Poor old Hammer. You drag his star down from the sky and stomp on it. Calling him a criminal, a thief. I won't forget this. You listen to me, whippersnapper. What? My poor old Hammer would never do such a thing. Why would he steal Powers' costume so he could sneak past me? He would never stoop so low. It's impossible. It's really not. Why are you pressed? There's people here? I guess they're not filming today either. I did want to see them filming just one time. This trial will be over tomorrow. We'll be over and done by tomorrow. You can come see them film later, I guess. This is where you found that bottle of sleeping pills, right? Uh-huh. I wonder if there's any other clues lying around. Yarr! What? Why is he here? No touching. Why are you mad, sir? Oh, sorry, pal. Didn't mean to frighten you. Didn't mean? I almost had a heart attack. I guess I can be a little dramatic at times. I suppose it's the actor in... What? The actor in you, sir? Dramatique, indeed. Ahem. Anyway, I'm here to examine the plate on that table. Wait, are you looking for the sleeping pills? Four sleeping pills? Yeah, pal. Traces thereof. So you're looking for plate traces of the sleeping pills? How? For a thorough examination, I gotta take the plate back to the precinct. But I have the capabilities to make a cursory examination right here. Our science guy gave me some testing solution. This reacts to these sleeping pills, see? If there's no traces, it'll change color. Wow, neat! So, Detective Gumshoe, what are you waiting for? Now, everything in due time, pal. No, do it now. The testing solution on the plate changed color, alright. Uh-oh. Damn it. So the food on this plate had been laced with sleeping pills. Wait, pause. I thought it was changing color if it didn't. I guess I was wrong. Looks like it. Ooh. Uh-oh. Alright. To tell the truth, it's a real mess, pal. Some people think we should pursue the case we already have against Powers. And some people think we should switch suspects. What do you think, Detective Gumshoe? Well, pal, I hate to admit it, but I'm not sure I buy the case against Powers anymore. I feel kind of bad for Mr. Edgeworth, though. Why? That man does not pay you? How is Edgeworth doing, anyway? Mr. Edgeworth is out of control. He was in the waiting room and he crushed his paper cup with hot, hot coffee in it. Talk about burns, pal. The fury of Edgeworth. Wow. Yeah, crushing paper cups. Woo. cups, bottles? Say, whatever happened to with that empty bottle? Oh, the bottle of sleeping pills? Well, I got some good news for you about that. They found the victim Jack Hammer's fingerprints on that bottle. Hey, he's helping us? Interesting. So that means... Yep, it sounds like the one who put Powers to sleep was none other than the victim. So I was right! There you go. Damn. Can't wait to see hear the twist on that. Like, oh. No, for real, I actually have no clue what it could possibly be. Penny, hello. What are you doing here? I was just cleaning up the dressing room. I guess WP won't be using it anymore, so... Anymore? Why? But WP's innocent. Yes, and I'm really grateful for all you've done. But this week is the last episode of Steel Samurai. What? What? No! Any reasons? Why? I was wondering if I could ask you about Mr. Hammer. Yes, on the day of the murder, he went to Studio 2. Huh? I thought he went to Studio 1. He stole the samurai costume too. What? Why would Mr. Hammer do such a thing? Oh, I guess the rumor must be true then. Huh? The rumor? Yeah, Miss Vasque, the producer, had some kind of hold on Hammer. She had some dirt on him. He'd do anything she said, apparently. Some dirt? What dirt? Dirt, you know, the bad stuff. Okay, but what specifically, Mom? I have an idea, but like... No. It's probably not what I think. Some films, anyways. About 5 years ago, they were filming a movie starring Mr. Hammer. They were using the new studio, Studio 2. Some sort of accident happened during filming. After that, they never used Studio 2 again. They left the film set the way it was, too. The film set? Was that the trailer part of the film set, then? What do you mean the last episode? I know it's a shock, but nothing can be done to save it now. Whoever really did kill Mr. Hammer also signed the Steel Samurai's death warrant. Yeah, there's no villain. I mean, they could. I don't know. It's very awkward. That's like very urgent casting. And I don't know how things go in the entertainment industry about that stuff. Also, I hear that Global Studios is going to change its programming. They're not going to make kid shows anymore. What? Why? I don't know. It's sad, but that's what Global Studios decided. Damn. Why aren't they going to make kid shows? The studio bigwigs don't want the Steel Samurai around anymore. They want to forget all this ever happened. They want it quiet, you understand? Yeah, so they don't want it a part of their image. How can they just do that? What about all the kids who love Steel Samurai? It's okay, I'm sure the kids will be fine. They'll find a new hero to follow. No, that can't be true. If the program just ends, they'll be heartbroken for sure. Nick, say something. I don't care. Yeah. I think evidence rather than words is called for here. Here, take a look at this. And this is? A fan collected all these photographs. The kids love the Steel Samurai. The show shouldn't be canceled just so some adults can save face. I would think you would better understand that than... you would understand that better than anyone. You're right. But what can I do? Well, for starters, you can tell me something. Tell me what it is that the Global Studios is so intent on hiding. Tell me about the incident 5 years ago. Okay. Could you tell us what happened 5 years ago? Well, I can tell you what I've heard. Apparently 5 years ago, someone died, and it was Hammer's fault. It was an accident, of course. Anyway, the producer, Miss Vasque, managed to hush it up. And that's the dirt she had on Mr. Hammer. Oh. Okay, it was an accident, but like, did he kill somebody? So that's why Mr. Hammer would do anything Miss Vasque asked him to do. But it was an accident. Why didn't they make it public? Just make it public? I mean, someone...
was shady, and they try to obviously blame him, right? Well, you know, Mr. Hammer was a big star back then. They were afraid about what would happen to his career if word got out. Or that. You know who knows more about this? Miss Olbat. She was here at the studios back then, you know? Thanks, I'll try asking her if she'll talk. Anyways. Alright, this was cool. Why am I doing better detective work than the detectives? You know, no. It's not really detective work. It's more like I'm doing better questioning, you know? What, you're still slinking around? If you like the place so much, why don't you take over for me? Everybody's doing their darnest to forget Hammer. Who do they think made Global Studios what it is today? Hammer, it's all due to Hammer. To froth at the mouth, what do you mean? We should keep a safe distance, stop, please. Okay, a bit more questioning. I wanted to ask you about 5 years ago. Who told? Who did you hear that from? Nicholas. Nicholas. Nick. Penny Nichols. Oh, Nichols. My bad. That assistant we talked to. Oh, right. Anyway, we heard about that incident. It was during filming with Jack Hammer. He killed a man, didn't he? Whippersnappers. Dredging up dirt on someone's past like that, and the recently departed, no less. Doesn't mean they should be celebrated in silence. I suppose you think this is fun? No, I'm just doing my job to protect Mr. Powers. And you claim that Hammer stole Powers' costume. You expect me to believe that rubbish? Or do you have some kind of proof? I do. I can prove that Mr. Hammer stole Mr. Powers' costume. What? What's a little empty bottle supposed to prove? It's a bottle of sleeping pills with Mr. Hammer's fingerprints on it. What does that prove? I'm sure old Hammer had some sleepless nights. Where's the proof that he used those pills on Powers? Yes, so this is a plate that he used to eat that steak. There are traces of sleeping pill powder on the plate. I see. Poor Hammer. You did wrong, Hammer. Rest your soul. Okay, you win. I'll talk. I'm tired, see? Tired of holding it all in. Why didn't you just quit? 5 years? You've been working here for 5 years? You're right. 5 years ago, there was an incident. A fatal accident. Excuse me. What's worse, a paparazzi took a photo of it. That photo, well, it caused quite a stir. And guess who made it all better? Vasque. She has ties to the Mafia. Oh. She silenced that paparazzi. That was the beginning. After that, she became a force to be reckoned with here at the studio. But you have to understand, poor old Hammer never meant to harm anyone. Hold on a minute. Here, take this. Oh, and that's the... Ooh, shit. That's how the person died, huh? It was a tennis match? What is this? This is the picture. Is this the trailer in Studio 2? Hammer was supposed to fight with the bad guy on top of the stairs over there. He pushed the other actor, and the man fell onto the flower pit... oh my god, what the fuck is wrong with me? On the flower box fence. Trying to read too fast, that's what it is. But also, yikes, man. Oh, that's a very painful way to go. How did you get this? It was a long time ago. I don't feel much like talking about it. I understand. I trust it. Think back, Nick, to the day of the murder.
But thinking back, Mr. Hammer put on the Steel Samurai costume. Then he left there to Studio 2. I don't even know what she said. But why? I wonder if someone called him? Like the producer? Or the director or the producer? Uh-huh. I think it's Salmonella. To be honest. Mostly because I'm like, oh, she has ties to the mafia. It's too obvious now. But they might just stick with it. Hey, Nick. It's Miss Fesque. Hello? Hello? Hey. H-E-L-L-O. Maya. You should at least try to be polite. I'm watching the clouds. Alright. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna save. Because for now, I actually do have to end the stream. But I will potentially be back sometime early tomorrow. Because I have a bit of extra time. So I wanna maybe see if I can slap out this case by then. Hopefully. Oh, goodness gracious. But, yeah, thank you. Thanks to all who came to watch and came to hang out. I appreciate it. And I hope to see some of you next stream. Bye!